welcome to one more programming tutorial on the SwiftUI topic. This video is a follow-up to the last one, where we talked about the new sidebar adaptable style in TabView. We met how the top bar on iPad is converted into a sidebar when applying the style, but in addition to that, we also met how to group tabs in sections using the also new TabSection container view. Continuing from the code example we just left off last time, the problem that exists here is how multiple tabs in sections appear when the app is running on iPhone, or even more generally, in the compact horizontal size class. In that case, the available screen space is limited. Therefore, the sidebar does not show up at all. On top of that, tab sections don't have any effect too. So, when there's a crowd of tabs and sections that might be looking good on iPad, on the compact horizontal size class, like the iPhone screen, all tabs are shown one after the other. If they are more than 5, then the more tab appears automatically, and users are led to a list of the remaining tabs, as you can see in the canvas here. Even though that's a default behavior, it's usually an unwanted appearance and against the best user experience. But we can fix things with just a bit of additional effort. All we need to do is to show and hide tabs in sections based on the horizontal size class of the view. So, we'll determine that by accessing the horizontal size class environment value already existing in SwiftUI. Next, we can follow two different paths. The first is to use conditional statements and display the one or the other, depending on what we need to hide and show in the compact horizontal size class. In our example over here, let's suppose that we'd like to totally hide the section with the additional tabs, and show just another tab instead. So, initially I'm cutting the section from here temporarily, and I'm adding a condition. If the size class has the regular value, or in other words is not compact, we'll show the section. Otherwise, we'll add a new tab in the else clause, which will be visible on iPhone and in compact horizontal size class only. That said, check out the canvas to see that the new collaborate tab is there indeed. The automatic more button does not exist any longer, and the tabs of the section are also missing. The second way to conditionally hide and show tabs in sections is to use the hidden modifier. Back in code, let's replace this condition with the section and the additional tab view, having the one after the other. I'm going right after the closing of the tab section and I'm applying the hidden modifier. I'm telling it to hide the section if the horizontal size class is compact. I'm applying the exact opposite logic to the new tab, specifying here to be hidden if only the horizontal size class is not compact. You can see once again that the iPhone in canvas contains only the new tab. Switching to the iPad simulator, see that the tab section becomes visible again, while the collaboration tab is no longer here. To keep things simple here, I only focused on the tab section and one tab. Needless to say, but you can conditionally show and hide any number of tabs and sections necessary in order to manage the best result for both compact and regular size classes. Let's focus now on how we can let users customize the sidebar and the top bar when the app is running on iPad. When supporting customization, users can reorder tabs in sections, show and hide tabs on demand, drag new tabs from the sidebar to the top bar, and remove tabs from the top bar. Certain actions are required from us to enable this functionality. The first step is to store any customization that users will perform, and for that we need a state property that will keep an instance of a particular type called TabViewCustomization. The customization property can be either a simple state property like here, or it can be an app storage property, so any changes are stored persistently in user defaults. With this property in place, let's move on to the next step. We'll go right after the tab view, and we'll use a modifier called TabViewCustomization. The argument to pass here is the binding value of the customization property. With that, any changes made to the tab view will update the property. Finally, let's pass to the third and last step. That's a bit longer, because we have to set distinct identifiers to all tabs and sections that we'll make customizable. Let's go right after the first tab, and let's add the first customization identifier. We apply the customization ID modifier, and we provide a unique string value. Apple recommends to use the reverse domain notation, such as com.appname.tabtitle. For the first tab, that will be com.sidebarAdaptableDemo.dashboard. In the same way, let's add all the rest. It's important to note a few things. Initially, if you skip applying the customization ID of any tab, this tab won't be customizable. Second, you may avoid setting a customization ID to a section, but to set it for the contained tabs. In that case, users will be able to customize tabs, but not to reorder them. If, on the other hand, you specify a customization ID for the section, then you mandatorily need to specify customization identifiers for the contained tabs as well. That said, we've performed all actions to enable customization at this point. However, not everything works in Canvas, so we'll go to the iPad simulator. Notice the enumerated button in the sidebar. When tapped, both the sidebar and the top bar change to edit mode. From here, users can do whatever they want with the tabs. They can enable or disable their appearance. They can reorder tabs in the section. They can drag tabs from the sidebar to the top bar. They can remove tabs from the top bar, but they can also reset everything back to their original state. So, now you know how to allow user customization when displaying the tab view using the sidebar adaptable style. You also know how to deal with multiple tabs and sections, and how to show tabs conditionally on the compact horizontal size glass. Please check out the description for links to the previous two videos, which all regard great improvements in tab view. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, don't forget to share it. Also, make sure to click like and subscribe to my channel for new videos that will come next. Thanks for joining me and for watching. Take care and see you next time.